morning students. Now we are talking about our lesson tissue. So in my earlier classes I have completed plant tissue. Now we will go for the animal tissue. So animal tissues are mainly of four kinds. Those are epithelial tissues, muscular tissues, connective tissues and nervous tissues. So animal tissues are mainly of four kinds. Epithelial tissues, muscular tissues, connective tissues and nervous tissue. So you are not acquainted with all types of tissues. Nervous tissue, you have acquisition of the nervous tissue. So we will talk about other tissues, and at last in detail we are going to talk about nervous tissue. Even you have already learned in class, in cell lesson we have already learned about nervous tissue, but then too we will go in detail for the same. But today we are going to talk about very important animal tissue, that is epithelial tissue. So today's our topic is epithelial tissue. This epithelial tissue is also, it also has various types. So all types we are going to talk in detail, but some of the common characteristics of epithelial tissue we will see today. So epithelial tissue is present on our body. Whole body is actually covered by epithelial tissue. Epithelial tissue is performing the main function of protection. So all epithelial tissue, all over our body, our whole body is covered by epithelial tissue. So the main function of the epithelial tissue is actually protection or covering of the body. See, covering and linings are the different terms. During my topic I shall explain you covering and lining. So this epithelial tissue performing role for both covering also and lining also. So epithelial tissue's main function is to cover our body. So what covers our body? Yes, correct, skin is covering our body. So skin is one kind of epithelial tissue. So there are various types of the tissues in our body. Actually our hair, our nails, our other body parts, internal organs are all made up of the tissues. So actually what kind of tissues are present in every organ of our body we will see, but now we will discuss about epithelial tissue. So we will see some common characteristics of epithelial tissue. So characteristics will be the first point of it. As I say you, the main function of the epithelial tissue is covering or protecting our whole body. So the main function or main characteristic of epithelial tissue is covering our body and protecting inner parts of our body. This is the first characteristic of epithelial tissue. As it has to perform the role of protection, so it does not, means the cells intercellular spaces are absent. As intercellular spaces are absent means the cells are tightly packed because it has to perform the role of protection. If the cells would be loosely packed, then what can happen? The outer material also can come inside or inner material also can go outside. Isn't it? And that function, it does not perform. Other cells are performing that function. That we will see later our class. But it has to protect our whole body, and so that the cells are tightly packed, means continuous like this. If this is a cell, then these cells are continuous, means completely packed. The cells are completely packed. There is no gap in between. If there would be gap, then outer material or inner material can exchange, and that we should have to avoid in our body. And so that intercellular spaces are absent and the cells are tightly packed. Cells are tightly packed. Fifth one characteristic of this is actually these tissues are at the top, means the skin is actually epithelial tissue.
Of this tissue forms a continuous sheet, means there is no
inner part of the body. Of the body from what? Injury. Injury, sometimes injury, then infection. Infection and damage to.
Your mind, student, there are various excretory organs in our body.
characteristics of squamous epithelial tissue. The squamous epithelial tissues, the cells are very thin. The cell walls or the cells of this cell wall, no, cell walls are present only in the gland tissue. So cells are very, very thin or extremely thin cells are present. Then, second characteristic of squamous epithelial tissue. These I am talking about squamous epithelial tissue. Epithelial tissue characteristics we have seen just now. Now we are talking about some common characteristics of squamous epithelial tissue. How these tissues are designed? So, in this tissue, the cells are there and these cells are very thin. Okay? Or extremely thin cells are formed into the squamous epithelial tissue. Cells are flat. Cells are flat. Actually, it has to perform the role of a covering. So, cells has to be flat. So, the characteristic of a squamous epithelial tissue is cells are flat. And third characteristic of a squamous epithelial tissue is the cells are irregularly shaped.
Difference also between simple squamous epithelial tissue and stratified
green is present. So how even cakes are forming a different layer. So such kind of layers are formed into the stratified squamous epithelial tissues. So these tissues are not in a form of a single layer. Simple we have formed it is a single layer. But stratified squamous epithelial tissues are formed in the layers. So cells are formed into the layers. Cells are present into the form of layers. Layers are formed. You can resemble this with a cake or pastry. In pastry there are various layers. Okay. Here also cells are present in the form of layers because it has to perform the work of the protection. So layers will protect the inner part of the body. So what is the function performed by it? It prevents the wear and tear of the body. Prevent wear and tear. Okay.